is, and feminist art, is to position my work in the same platform where this white male art is being positioned. And once I enter those institutions, once I enter those space, I try to bring with me a conversation that is not only about the female art, which is how they talk to us, but a conversation about power. In a way that I'm talking to them as an equal, instead of somebody that belongs to another level. So that's for me feminist art. It's talking to the white, certainly European or American male, in a position of equals, and also appropriating all of these quote-unquote universal terms like power, justice, freedom, that they think are belong only to them to talk. But of course from the perspective of the singular person, which I think they lack. The challenges feminist art have is to try to use their own position to talk not only about themselves, but also to create a coalition or solidarity between all these other people and all these other identities that have been pushed down at the level of minority, as a level of the other, and to bring with them not only their own cases, their own issues and goals, but with them the other people. So I think that's one thing that feminist artists can do that is actually even a duty in a way, you know, to be solidarity in that sense. But a big prejudice feminist art have, and feminists in general, is to be accused of a few things. First of all, to be accused of having too narrow of an issue to deal with, therefore it's not interesting because they consider, because it's a female issue, it's not important. So this is one challenge that many feminist artists have. And another one is to be judged and be having some sort of character assassination, some sort of like accusation of everything that will be quote-unquote seen negative in society. I agree, I think there is a need to feminize art in the art world, because look how many women and girls study art and how many famous or empowered artists, female artists there are. The proportion makes no sense. So even if there are so many female and girls art students, the artists, female artists who arrive to recognition level are very few. Or, for example, you have cases like Susan Lacy, Lynn Hirschman, and Martha Wilson, and all these artists, Karen Finley, all these artists who did an amazing work in the 70s shaping performance art as we know it today, and not being given the credit for what they did. You know, you have Susan Lacy who participate in social engaged art and actually have shaped the language in which we talk about it, the attitude we have to. Lynch Hirschman talking about technology and art. And all of these women have shaped their history we know today, but they had to wait until they are in the 80s, 70s and 80s, to be recognized. So I think there is a very important need to have feminist male artists and feminist male curators. So they understand that when somebody has produced a work that is important, not to look if it's a buddy, friend of his, but it is a good artist. But there is a thing that we need to combat, which is a lot of artists, male artists, who take female ideas and then produce it, and they have the relevance that the female artists did not have. They take their ideas, they take even the images sometimes, and some curator, knowing this, they do not stop the male artists and take the female artists and put it back in the place they should be. But the other thing is that we have a very bad prejudice in which many female curators and many female art historians want to do their career or have empowerment or have a, not empowerment, have a, acquire capital in the art world by doing male exhibitions, like big famous male artist exhibition, instead of saying, you know what, I have no shame at all in doing my professional curatorial or art history research career by focusing in female artists that I think have values that I don't see in these male artists. So I think this is also a problem that we have to self-criticize. We have to have an autocritica, criticize ourselves, because we are also part of the problem. It's not only them, but ourselves. We need to be very vigilant, not to reproduce, because the easiest thing is to reproduce the models of oppression. Because we live on them, they feel comfortable. You know, oppression feels comfortable when it's not done to you, when you are doing it to somebody else. So I think we need to be very vigilant about our own role in this system.